left win in 2000, there's the recent 2020 local body poll. There are combination of several factors that led to that. Obviously, the Sprinkler or all the scam, Sprinkler, the gold scam, all the, when we say that all these scandals had an effect on the incumbent government, still they were able to make it through. So we have to divide it into three major events that had happened. Number one, the event is the growth of BJP in the state. Number two is in regard with the fiasco that happened in regard with Jose Kemani. And number three, in regard with how people are perceiving the Congress party, as well as how their own cadre is not happy with. That is the three reasons. I will explain one by one. Number one, growth, while we are accepting that there is an anti-incumbency factor against CPIM, we have to understand the fact that when BJP is growing in the state, they have to cut into the votes of either LDF or UDF, because it's a two polar election, that bipolar election that had been happening for a lot of years. So if a third front is to come up, it should cut into the votes of someone, either one of these polls. So from a 0.4% vote share, BJP has reached 15% vote, 4% vote share in 2010 local body election to 15% vote share in 2020 local body election. So if you are seeing that there is an 11% shift in votes. So 11% shift in votes is huge in regard with any state. So what really happened was that the people who used to vote, especially Nayars and other smaller Hindu voter group like the Vishwakarma Samajam, who used to vote for BJP, who used to vote for the Congress or the UDF, they actually shifted the votes from there, shifted to BJP. And the percentage of vote shift from LDF is very, very less, very, very minute. So LDF, even though they didn't get as much as vote as the previous election, they were still was able to be at the top, because UDF lost their votes from their own kitty and it went to BJP. So BJP eating into Congress is one major factor why Congress lost elections throughout the state in local body. Number two,
It seems very interesting, like especially when we saw the statement by Pinrai Vijayan also, he stated that the Muslim League is making decision for the Congress in Kerala. So there is an ongoing sentiment that there is the Congress is going towards maybe unwritten alliances with the Muslim party as such, but then the shift of votes is like that's the reason why you're having the shift of votes of the mainly the Nayars or the other Hindu communities.
See, you are absolutely right, Joel, in regard with the state, in regard with what you said. The important thing here is the fact that now LDF is in a place where they have a consolidated Muslim vote, and they don't know that they are not going to lose that whatever consolidated Muslim vote they are having. On the other hand, UDF, as they are knowing that they are losing hugely on LDF, hugely on the Hindu vote due to the factor of BJP, they are actually trying to get as much as Muslim votes as they could. And in that bigger scheme of things, they are going for because they are not in power, they cannot go for any minority appeasement policies in the government because they are not in power, but they can do minority appeasement policies inside the party or inside the UDF system. that is why they are trying to do that, so that they can compensate the loss of Hindu votes by getting more Muslim votes from wherever they can find. That is one. That is why they did that. And growing power, the growing power of Muslim League inside UDF had all has always been a concern for the Hindu majority groups in the state. Like very recently, Vellapalli Nadesan, who we have mentioned earlier, stated that Hindu consolidation, majority Hindu consolidation, is a must in the state, so as to so as to tackle the Muslim in double quote menace of the state. So that is what he literally said a few days back. So that is one major factor. So the caste politics and the religious and the caste politics in the state is becoming very, very bad to an extent.
But notice the shift of the Christian votes also towards different parties than because the usual norm is that the Kerala Congress is always a Christian backed party, or the UDF has even them on board. But then you had the polls turn upside down with regard to the LDF and the NDA getting some of the votes of the Christians.
Yeah, that is actually very true. I mean, that is the second point that I was about to mention about Jose Kemani. Jose Kemani was, Jose Kemani and the Kerala Congress Mani group had been the founding members of, you can even call Kemani, who was the former chairman of Kerala Congress Mani, was the founding member of UDF. When a party like Jose Kemani's Kerala Congress left UDF to go to LDF, the left front, actually there was a huge shift in Catholic vote, especially in the central Kerala belt where Christians are in majority, that actually went exclusively to LDF. So you can see a municipality like Pala or a municipality like Changanacheri, which had traditionally been a UDF or Congress bastion, went with the left. That is because of the shift that occurred due to the movement of Kerala Congress Mani group from, and a very important factor which resulted in the victory of LDF. And the last factor which I was speaking about was the cadre of Congress party is not happy. Actually, they are not happy. The problem is that they do not have a leader going into this election, even though they want to project Ramesh Chennithal as the leader, the next CM candidate. They are not able to do that. The cadre lacks a good leadership. And because of that, they are not able to consolidate the sure shot vote. Even the sure shot vote, they are not able to consolidate. There are different names that are doing the rounds, including Ramesh Chennithal. Then former CM Uman Chandy. Uman Chandy actually has some health issues. That is why he is not in and is not able to talk. And that is why he is not in the news these days. Then there is KC Venugopal, who is considered to be the right hand of Rahul Gandhi, and is one of the reason why Rahul Gandhi contested from Wayanad. Then other names include former Chief Minister Karunakaran's son, K. Muralidharan. All these names are doing around. Even when you are looking at these names which are doing the rounds, you can actually find that out of the four names I mentioned, except for Umar Jandi, all three are Hindu Nayars. So I think if Congress actually want to get back the Nayar votes, which BJP took from their hand, they should field a good, strong Nayar candidate. Because of this loss of leadership, because there is no strong leadership, is also the reason why left was able to win the election.
I'm sorry, but even that being the case, there were like even statements which were brought forth, which almost went about the state that BJP, both BJP and UDF in the state, almost coincided in the way they were. Because one of such popularized comments, especially during local body elections, were like, yeah, in the state, both BJP and UDF like work hand to hand, or they are like working in association to each other. And this was to an extent that both of their opinions, both of their stands on, especially in cases like, you know, even in the case of Shabrimala also, like it seems that both of them did proceed with the very similar norms in, you know, very similar way of moving. I think this would also create a kind of impact on people, along with the obviously the point that Sir is stating, that a lack of a proper leadership in the KRL, along with internal corrosions as well, because they themselves inside the parties are not united, for which there are issues within them to be resolved at first hand.
Maria, it's a party time, without a president. So you won't have any head. It has no head.
Yeah,
so
like
I mean, they do not have a president right at the center itself. So
it's a chicken without a head. It's like a chicken.
And above all, the kind of you know, the kind of support that Mr. Ramesh Shettila receives, or the kind of support expected to a Chief Minister candidate, I guess like there is a better popular feeling towards our former Chief Minister Mr. Upan Chanti than how it is to Mr. Ramesh Shettila nowadays. So I think almost all these points consolidate a lot towards the kind of impact UDF is facing right now in Kerala, which I don't know how far it will be resolved in the upcoming elections, which almost brings us to a, you know, I don't know how to make this statement, but a kind of prediction is coming in a lot of people's minds, where I could hear a lot of debates and all coming up stating that, okay, the results are kind of going to be left side, I'm not really sure. These are the kinds of statements that are coming up because of these very relevant points. So do you guys have a say on this aspect of the game as well?
Maria, if there is no tectonic shift that is happening in Kerala's politics in the upcoming months, in the upcoming next 2 months, I believe CPIM, even though I'm not a big fan of, I was never a big fan of CPIM and LDF, is going to come back to power. And this will be the first government after independence of independence to win an anti-incumbent, because you look at the history of Kerala, once it's Congress, next time it will be Communist Party, then Congress, then Communist Party. That had been the rule, or that had been the, always it had been like that. But this will be the first election where an incumbent government will continue to rule.
So you're saying it's going to be as easier than Bengal and Tamil Nadu as well? Because Bengal is an anti-incumbency as well.
Bengal has an anti-incumbency of 10 years. Tamil Nadu has an anti-incumbency of 10 years.
Yeah.
In regard with Bengal, BJP's growth there had been monumental. The number of, in a place where they had been winning 3-4 parliamentary seats, they won more than 15 parliamentary seats. And they are the major opposition party there. And knowing Amit Shah, he is not going to lose that particular this thing. And this he considered it as a very pride thing. So it will be very hard for Mamata to retain. I mean, to an extent, what I am hearing, the chit-chat from the ground, it's going to be BJP in the 2021 election, it's going to be in BJP. If you ask about Tamil Nadu, it is going to be,
or at least they will be the main opposition in Bengal. Even if they don't
They will be main opposition. If not ruling the state, they will, for 100% sure, they will be the main opposition in Bengal. There is no doubt in that. They will be having a lot more Rajya Sabha MPs coming into from Bengal anyway. In regard with Tamil Nadu, it is very interesting. This is the first election after two big banyan trees fell. Two giants of Dravidian politics fell in the past 5 years. So this is the first election after that kind of an incident. There is no Karunanidhi. This is the first election without Karunanidhi and without Jayalalitha. So it is going to be difficult, but Stalin being Stalin is not having that much, the aura of Kalinger is never with Stalin. And Stalin being Stalin, saying different things like, he makes mistakes in saying simpler things, and people do not have that value that is associated with, that used to associate with Kalinger, with Stalin. So people are in double minds. I'm working in Tamil Nadu, so I can for 100% say that Stalin is not going to have a easy time ahead.
And that's why in Pongal, like especially, so sorry to cut you, especially in this festival time, you're seeing Congress and BJP coming into Tamil Nadu state and trying to do something.
Yeah, yeah. Congress, BJP is in alliance with AIADMK and Congress is in alliance with BMK. It's a 50-50 contest. If you are asking me, it is a 50-50 contest happening in Tamil Nadu with a slight advantage towards AIADMK without any doubt. Because Edappadi Palaniswamy, how he had handled COVID and the investment that he has brought in, the different populist schemes that he was able to provide to the people, he is a clear favorite. He's a clear favorite, but then I cannot say it's going to be a huge victory like how Amma used to have or how Kalinger used to have. He's not going to have that, but it's a slight advantage AIADMK in Tamil Nadu. But our main point is coming back to Kerala itself.
Yeah, that's right. So how would it be in Kerala, like with all these aspects taken into consideration? 2021 is going to be a year.
The problem, I will tell you, the north, always the northern part of Kerala, the Malamar region, except for Malappuram, always had been the bastion of left. They are going to win majority seats there. Now, when you come to central Kerala, was the region where UDF used to compensate for what they have lost in the north. This time around, there is no Kerala Congress to give that Christian vote advantage. So they are going to lose terribly there. For example, in a state where the Kerala originated, in a district like Kottayam, out of only two seats are properly assured for Congress. One seat where Umman Chandy contests, and another seat where the Kottayam constituency, where former minister Mr. Radhakrishnan contests. So other than that, it is going to be extremely so. The central, it's because of Kerala Congress money group. Again, central will also be going largely towards the left. When you go south, you can see Alappi had always been a very strong left. Kollam had always been left. Kollam had always been strong left. In south, in Trivandrum also, you can see that because BJP grew, you can see that LDF is there, then BJP is there, and Congress is its distant third. Like, if you can see the Nemam constituency where Congress, where BJP won last time in Trivandrum, or Rajagopal got around more than 65,000 votes. The second, it was Shivankutty of CPIM, who got around 7,000 votes less than or Rajagopal. And the third place where the UDF, the Congress front contested, he had got only 16,000 votes, 15,000 votes. See the difference there. It's a difference of around 50,000 votes between the third place and the second place. So all the constituencies where BJP has gained, Congress has lost terribly. If you're asking me now, the question is, like, I cannot say a particular number, but it's always, it's right now, it's huge major advantage for Communist Party in the state. Most probably, Pinarayi Vijayan will continue as the Chief Minister. Now, if you ask me what are the chances of BJP, which is a question that I always get, especially being from Kerala, if I believe Nemam constituency, which they sitting seat, they will retain that with Kumbanam Rajasekaran coming in place of the 90-year-old, the 90-plus-year-old or Rajagopal. Kumbanam Rajasekaran will come there and will settle the seat. Other than that, they might win maybe maximum 2-3 more in around Trivandrum area.
Yes, sir. So, like rightly pointed out, and even like a lot of BJP leaders on stating about how they're going to perform for 2020 elections and things of this sort, like a common comment made on the part of the BJP was also like, okay, our progress, or the progress of BJP in Kerala has always been aimed to be slow. It is like, even if we see the election results that have been coming up, they are trying to catch them like one by one. They're trying to acquire seats one by one or areas one by one. and the kind of impact that they're trying to create, even though it's slow in nature, they're trying to create a very concrete or strong base in the area. And also, undoubtedly, the allegations they made against the plan, or the so-called plan made by the central agencies to bring down the government and all, were really well deliberated and debated, like, throughout the tenure, I must say. Or at least throughout this one particular year where we saw a lot of scams and all these things getting exposed. And even the most recent developments, including the youngest mayor in the country, Ms. Sarya Rajendran, who became the 21-year-old mayor. So all these things, or all these projections of developments, so I repeat the word projections of development, per se has impacted like pretty well with respect to Kerala. And like Sir had rightly pointed out, is quite going to be reflecting in the upcoming assembly elections as well. And so further, like rightly, as rightly stated, the role of BJP as a whole in the state will definitely impact Congress, I mean, so for the UDF per se in the state, because automatically and obviously sentiments stating that, like I just stated about, UDF and BJP tend to behave like a team in Kerala, like nowadays, as analysts and all say. I think that's also going to affect this person.